In this video, we're going to be taking a look at some more probability rules. We already covered the first three in the last video. And we're going to jump around a little bit. The next probability rules that I'd like to look at in this book are numbers 7 and 8. And 7 is looking at actually a definition. It's less of a rule and more of a definition. And it says events A and B are mutually exclusive if the probability of A and B is equal to 0. Mutually exclusive is just another way of saying that two events can't occur together. Okay, so that's exactly what this is saying. The probability of A and B occurring together is equal to 0. In other words, it is not possible for those two events to occur together. They are mutually exclusive by definition. Now, why do we care about mutual exclusivity? Well, there is a rule number 8 in the book. These are our addition rules. Addition rules are what you will use to calculate probabilities for or events. If you want to link together two or more events using the logical connective or and find the probability of that occurring, you'll use these addition rules. And there's two versions of them depending on whether or not your events are mutually exclusive. The general addition rule you can use regardless of whether your events are mutually exclusive or not. You can use it all the time. And it says that the probability of A or B occurring is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A and B. Okay, that's the general addition rule. Now, for mutually exclusive events, if you know that your two events are mutually exclusive, then you know that the probability of this AND statement is equal to 0. So that means that this part of the formula would essentially disappear. And the statement for the probability of A or B occurring simplifies to just probability of A plus probability of B. You don't need to do this subtraction piece because that would be equal to 0 for mutually exclusive events. Now, where do these rules come from? For those of you that have seen Venn diagrams, this will make some sense. If you haven't seen a Venn diagram, hopefully this visual representation will still make some sense. But imagine that here is our sample space, our big rectangle. That's our sample space. And that each of these circles represents one of our two outcomes, outcome A and outcome B. So these are two possible things that could occur within the sample space. Now, if we have two events that are not mutually exclusive, it means they could occur together. There could be some overlap between A and B. Okay. So if I want to find what's the probability that A occurs or B occurs, I'm looking at this entire area within both of these circles. But if I just try and take those two circles and add them together as they are, here's probability of event A. Here's probability of event B. And if I simply add those two together, you can see that I've counted this overlap twice. I counted it both with probability of A and with probability of B. So I need to subtract it off one time to compensate, to avoid double counting it. So that's where the general rule comes from. Now, for mutually exclusive events, the reason that we don't see that is because if two events are mutually exclusive within the sample space, it means they don't overlap, right? They can't both occur at the same time, so there's no overlap in the middle. So here I can safely take probability of A and add on probability of B, and not have to subtract anything off because there isn't any overlap. Okay, and that's where the addition rules come from. So here's an example of how we might apply this. Let's say that we had some information about M&Ms, and let's say that the colors we were working with were purple, yellow, red, orange, green, blue, and brown. And here are our percentages. So we have 20% purple, 20% yellow, 20% red, and then all the rest are 10%. So orange is 10, green is 10, blue is 10, and brown is 10. Okay, these are our percentages. Now, let's say we want to know, we're going to take a large bag of M&Ms, we're going to draw out one single candy from the bag, and let's say we want to know what's the probability of getting a purple or green candy on that draw. I can see I'm using the logical connective or, so I'm going to be using one of the addition rules. And then the question that I need to ask myself when I'm looking at these addition rules is, are the events that I'm dealing with mutually exclusive? Because if they are, I use the simpler version of the formula. If they're not, I use the general version. So for mutually exclusive, two events can't occur together. Is it possible for me to draw out a candy that is simultaneously purple and green? Well, with M&Ms, we know that's not possible. They're only one color. So these are mutually exclusive, which means that the probability of purple or green is just going to equal probability of purple plus probability of green. I don't need to subtract off the overlap because there isn't any. It's not possible to have purple and green at the same time. So here's my 20%, here's my green is 10%, so there is a 30% chance of that occurring. Now let's look at another example of two events. Let's say that this time we just have some background information. Let's say we know that probability of event A occurring is, let's say, 80%, and probability of event B occurring is 40%. And let's say the first thing that we want to know is, can events A and B be mutually exclusive? Okay, one way to answer this question, since we don't have background information the way that we had about the M&Ms, I don't know anything about A and B, so I can't determine just by looking at this if they're mutually exclusive. But one thing I can do is to think about probability of A or B. Now, if these two events were mutually exclusive, I should just be able to add their individual probabilities together to get the probability of the OR statement. But here, if I do that, what ends up happening, 80% and 40%, that's 120%, okay? 1.20. Since we already said that something can't happen more than all of the time, they must not be mutually exclusive, because when I add them together, that doesn't make any sense to consider them mutually exclusive. So no, they're not. Which means that if I want to calculate the probability of the OR statement, I need some additional information. So let's say that we want to compute probability of A or B if probability of A and B is equal to 0.6. No, sorry. Let's say compute probability of A or B if probability of A and B is equal to, let's say, 0.2. Okay. So if that's what I want to do, and I already know that the events are not mutually exclusive, probability of A or B has to equal probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A and B. That's the case for non-mutually exclusive events. That's the general rule. So probability of A, 0.8, plus 0.4, minus 0.2. And now we're looking at 0.8 plus 0.4 would be 1.2 minus 0.2. This would be 1, or 100%. And that's the idea with the addition rules, rules 7 and 8. In the next video, we'll take a look at rules 4, 5, and 6.